Hi there everyone, this is DJ from GarageBand.net Academy, and together with Vincent, we'll show you in this tutorial how to make automatic motion capture with Deepmotion. So let's run straight into Blender. But first let's check out Deepmotion. This is an online service you can register and sign in for a free trial. Just prepare a video and upload there into the Animate 3D Cloud. Select the file and upload your video. Now there's a few options that you can set here. I'll just use the default ones. And click Create Animations. As simple as that. The animations will be created automatically with an AI algorithm. And there you go. You can see the dummy character moves just the way you did. Does a pretty good job, unless it pick up a character that's very different from you. So you can create some artifacts like the mesh passing through itself. But generally, it's doing an okay job in creating at least the basic motions. There are a few tips to create your video to get the best result out of this algorithm, and there's a limit to the size of the video that you upload. So here I uploaded a version with a bit of a better capturing of myself, and as you can see, it runs pretty smoothly. Now after it's done, I can just click download animations and I'll choose the adult male, which in fact I am, and I'll pick the BVH file, which seemed to work best for me to import to Blender. I'll import the PVH to Blender, place it in my scene, just scale it appropriately. And there we have a dancing skeleton. Now let's go and link that ready armature to a pre-made character that I'll download from the Blender Cloud. I could use the sheep, but it's a bit different from me, so I'll just go with Vincent. It's a detailed rigged character, so I just got rid of the whole rig and simplified the mesh just to make things simpler. I just left the eyeballs as separate meshes. So let's adjust the scale of the armature to fit our character, and let's place it near our Vincent. But you can see the pose is pretty much different, so let's make sure in the pose mode that the armature is set to rest position, which is the T pose. And now let's place the armature and scale it accordingly to fit with our mesh. Now I'll go to edit mode and just move the key joints and make them fit the places where they should be. Just take your time and make it as accurate as possible, because it will affect the overall quality of your animation in the end. But just make sure you check all the three dimensions of it, so go to front view, side view and the top view, and make sure the armature fits the mesh perfectly. Once it's done, we can make sure that the armature is visible all the time, so in the viewport display I'll click in front. That's a cool trick that can make things easier for you. And now the key part, let's bind the mesh with the armature. And to do that, you need to select the mesh first and then shift select the armature as well and press Ctrl P and select armature deform with automatic weights. What it does, it gives the mesh the armature modifier. Oh, here's an old one, let's get rid of it. And it binds with vertex groups. So let's check the mesh options here and vertex groups. You can see there are a lot of groups there for each bone of the armature. And now if you select the armature and go to the pose position, you can see that the animations applied to the armature are also applied to the mesh. Oh, you can see just the eyeballs are left over because, well, they were separate meshes. So let's repeat this whole process to the eyeballs as well. Just picking the eyeball and the armature and parenting it with automatic weights. And the eyeballs follow the armature as well. If you take a look at the mesh in the weight painting mode, just select some vertex groups. You can see that the weights are there already, automatically assigned. So if anything goes wrong with the automatic weights, you can always go to the weight painting mode and just correct things. But that's a topic for a whole new video. The animation is pretty much ready. I'll just place it in some environment and light it and use a render beamer plugin to use GarageBand.net cloud rendering service to render the whole animation in cycles. The render beamer uploaded, and I'll just make sure to run some test frames first, just to make sure they render correctly. So I'll do that with a step, just to render every 50th frame, and I'll go with a GPU because cycles is just faster with GPU. Once the frames are rendered, they automatically download to the drive and I can check they look fine, so I can run the full job, and here's how it looks like in the end. Pretty dope, and that was really quick and easy. So now go on and make your own animations, even if you're no animator at all. This is a real helper and it will jumpstart you with your character animation process. So if you liked the video, make sure to like, share and subscribe. Keep on rendering and see you in the next videos of GarageBand.net Academy.